for us.
Thank you, Zyrene. I'm joined by Bjergsen, Lustboy, and Loco Doco. After a very solid win, these games never seem to disappoint when you guys go up against CLG. They're plenty back and forth. So first to you, Bjergsen, as one of the longer standing members of the team and this rivalry at this point with all the newcomers. Talk to me about once again being able to, put the nail in the coffin over CLG there in one of these games.
It feels really, really good. Like I said yesterday, we scrimmed against CLG a lot, and they honestly looked like the strongest teams out of all the teams we scrimmed. And every single one of their performances in this last, like yesterday and last week, they've just looked so consistent and they've looked so strong. So I was pretty nervous going into this game because CLG just looked really solid. It looked like it was really hard to really break them, so it felt good to be able to do that.
Well, right. When we look at CLG, this split, we see them as a very strong team. So, Loco, to you, the fact that they've started off the split so well, you guys had somewhat of a rocky start with your very first game against C9. Having been able to beat CLG here must feel pretty good in terms of the evolution and the building up of this organization or the team through the summer split.
I mean, it feels great. Our mid game looked shaky in the game versus TIP and C9, and CLG's mid game looked really strong in the games they had. So, I was a bit worried, but our boys really played well. Lustboy and Bjergsen played extremely well in team fights, and they were able to carry the fight through.
Well, let's turn to Lustboy here now. Fantastic Bard play. We've seen you play that champion before, but most people, after seeing it left up there, would have assumed that Aframut took it. You took it instead and made some pretty humongous plays. Was this planned from the beginning to leave it up and take it away?
처음부터 오늘 할 수 있는 상황이 나오면 픽할 계획을 가지고 있었고 딱 마침 바드 픽하기 좋은 각이 나와서 바드를 픽하게 되었다.
Lust says we had it planned to pick Bard if the situation was right for it. Bard is a really hyped champion, so like the crowd cheers every time. Like, so we didn't pick it randomly; it was planned, and the situation came up, so we picked it.
We saw some incredible flash cosmic bindings there that really turned the game around when we moved into that mid game where, Loco, you were talking about CLG normally performs pretty well. There was one stumble for TSM where CLG managed to take a Baron off it and didn't look good for you guys, Bjergsen. What was communication like there in terms of getting yourselves righted as a ship and, getting back into the groove of things and finally turning that fight in the mid lane?
I think we just all felt like We had a hiccup, we made a mistake, but still overall we have been playing well that game and everyone felt confident in our comp later in the game. We had Sivir came out untouched in the early game and she just scales extremely well into team fights with the speed and the overall damage output. So we felt like our comp was going to outscale. Sure, they got a ban, but we can stall it out and they're going to have a hard time sieging.
Now, Lustboy, you were pretty instrumental in turning that fight as you had the flash over and you cosmic binding the Kalista and the Azir together. Big plays like that provide a lot of hype to the team, but how do you manage to keep your cool because there was still another 10 minutes of gameplay to follow that?
일단 솔로큐에서 바드를 한 지금 100판 넘게 플레이했고 딱 그 큐 플래시 각이 나와서 큐 플래시를 했고 딱히 팀이 팔로우할 수 있는 각인지는 생각하지 않았지만 바드 스턴이 너무 길기 때문에 팀이 충분히 팔로우할 수 있을 거라고 믿고 그냥 그 플레이를 만들었어요.
He played over 100 games of Bard in solo queue, so he's pretty confident about his queues. And he saw the opportunity and he went for it. He wasn't sure if the team could follow up because there was a lot of distance created by flashing and queuing, but he went for it because it was a really good opportunity to go for it.
All right, well, and it absolutely did pay off. Bjergsen, a more micro question here. Yesterday, you played LeBlanc into Azir. You find yourself in that matchup again today against Pobelter, and I just want to bring that up because this matchup, when we were looking at it, was going to be a big one. TSM, a pretty mid lane-centric team. CLG was looking to attack that mid lane a little bit. You didn't seem to have as easy of a time with the LeBlanc-Azir matchup today as you did yesterday.
I think in the majority of the lane, I had a pretty solid lead, like 20-30 CS. And then I made one mistake of trying to roam bot lane while Pobelter was backing. And as I stepped on a pink ward and cleared that instead, I lost a lot of tempo since he backed. And he got the Morello, so I was still stuck on the Phoenix Codex. So at that point, he was just a lot stronger than me, and that's why he really got the lane control. So if I had played it better, I had backed around the same time, I would have more gold, and I could keep that control in lane. So Pobelter just took advantage of my mistake, and he did that very well.
Very solid play from him in that regard. Now back to you, Loco. When we look at, you know, the TSM-CLG rivalry and the overall record, now moving to 15-9 when we include playoff games in favor of TSM, you guys have gotten the better of them the last few times. What do you attribute that most to? Because it always seems like CLG looks incredibly strong going into the match, but they fall short when they come up against you guys.
Well, I mean, I would probably say our players. I think we have the most talented players in NALCS. Bjergsen Lustboy, by far the best players in their role. Centaurin, really good. Turtle Dire is also really good. And our structure got better this season because we had one of our analysts, Parth, move into the house. So I would like to say our structure is better than theirs. I know they have a new coach and all that, but I feel really confident in our structure and our players.
Well, Lustboy, talking about the structure, how do you as a player feel that the structure, the team, the support staff that you have around you has helped you develop as an individual and as a team?
Very good, very good.
Well, very good is good. Bjergsen, anything to add with that when it comes to the support that is lent to you guys through the management and the coaches?
I think we've just been constantly improving overall. Since Loco joined, I think, almost a year ago, we've just really learned how the players should mesh with Loco and how Loco should mesh with the team and really how we should be towards each other. And I think that adding Parth in the house and also having our analyst Dylan online, it really helps out that we have pretty much every single side covered. As soon as they realize a mistake, like our mid game wasn't as good as it could have been against TIP, instantly they go back. They do a lot of prep work where they show us how we should go through this, what exactly should we do in the mid game with these kind of comps that we're playing. And today it showed our mid game was a lot better, and I can't credit that to anyone but our coaching staff.
Well, the structure is breeding excellence, no doubt. Once again, congratulations to all of you and the rest of the team on the win today. We are going to take a 3.5-minute break before diving into game 4 with TDK and Enemy Esports taking center stage. Here we're going to get a look at Team Dragon Knights and Enemy arriving just a short time ago. Now, they've faced off in the Challenger Series, but this is the first time they'll do battle on the LCS stage. So a big game for both of them to prove their worth and their value in the LCS. Don't go anywhere. The action continues after this.